Well, good afternoon, all of you avid viewers. This is the first video in my series describing how to get started with Defiance. Today I'm just going to run through character creation, the tutorial, and the ego grid, and a little bit of the menu system. So, why don't we get started? After you've done all your installation and patching, which, well, there will be a lot to do. Got a friend online. You get this screen, and it doesn't automatically take you in, so you have to obviously create a new character. I obviously have my main character, my second character, which I ended up not doing anything with, and this new character that I'm about to create. As I assumed friends to play Defiance with. You'll find that you end up adding an awful lot of people in the game because one of the pursuits within the game, something to do, is actually to have 15 people online at the same time. Having friends in the game is actually very useful because it allows you to teleport to them with ease. I will also be skipping all of the cutscenes just because I don't really want to ruin the story that's there. I personally enjoy it. And I'm glad that it was never ruined for me. Okay, so here we are, character creation. I'm twiddling around with one of the joysticks. With the other one, I can select whether it's human male, human female. It does take some time to load because it's obviously having to render a completely different person. And it irradiant male and female. I just can't say that species name. And then a Castavan male and Castavan female. The difference, as you can see, is the guys are bigger than the girls. And then the inherents have that weird nose merged eyebrow weird thing going on. And the Castavans have white, pale skin and white hair. And humans, well, they look like humans. You then have four origins. Veteran, who by the end of it you will have an assault rifle and pistol. Survivalist, you will have a sniper rifle and pistol. Outlaw, you will have a shotgun and pistol. And machinist, you will have an LMG and pistol. And then you've got some archetypes, which is just, in general, which type of face do you want. I'm going to quickly run through all of these so you can just see there isn't really much difference between them. Oh, that looks a bit weird. It's just the male faces show the difference more. My main character is this archetype, just felt he looked a bit tough. We continue with this. You've then got various bone structures. Now, it's not actually affecting his shoulders, it's just, as you can see, he's breathing very gently, and it just fast forwards the animation a little bit. It just changes the face a little bit. And so this is pretty much all of the thing. And then you got voices.
Hey.
Hey, buddy.
Soldier.
Hey, how's the violence?
What's up?
Hey, friend.
I personally like Lunatic, just because it's funny. You can then do a bit more in the eyes, the colour, even red eyes, or blue, green, or yeah, completely red eyes, geez. And different eyebrows. There are obviously the female characters and the inherent and humans have slightly different variations. Hair, for instance, the humans don't have a mohawk option. Or a mullet option. Let's go for old mohawk. Then you got hair colour. Basically these guys just dye any colour, whereas with humans, from what I had to look at, it was all very realistic colours. And then you can give them some facial hair. Now this is kind of going on from in the show that this particular species don't really grow facial hair. Whereas the humans, if you choose male and do facial hair, you get a full beard going or a moustache. So it's obviously, there is some personalisation. Then you've got some tattoos, which are race specific again. Blemishes, which appear also to be race specific, because these are different to the human ones I looked at yesterday. And the face paints are all different as well. So it's just having no face paint, no blemishes, no tattoos. Then you get to name your guy. As I'm doing this character for the Reddit videos, why not? Hopefully, it's not been taken. Create character. Am I sure? Yes. Drumroll. No one else has taken that character name. As I said, I will be skipping the cutscenes, just so this video is not too long, because it's already at the 6-minute mark. Yeah.
Now, Arcunner.
Hold on, Captain. That one isn't wearing your beloved uniform.
It's Lex Luthor. Anyway. Obviously, in between loading areas and cutscenes, there is a lot of loading screens in this, especially if you are playing through the storyline. Just because, well, there's a lot of cutscenes. Here we are. We're in the game. Not the pretty thing, but...
...need a signal when you're ready to proceed. Let's try it.
But, well, it's an Xbox game. PC doesn't look much better. PS3, about the same. This here is your ego woman. You basically have a implanted device within you which allows you to do funky things. And only I can see this. If there was another player here, they would not be able to see it. And actually, if you look on the mini-map in the top right-hand corner, we can see a pink dot. If I go run over towards that person...
Don't stray too far from my
protection. Ugh, fine, I'll come back.
Some behaviors before moving on.
So demanding.
Interface with me to signal when you're ready to proceed. Let's try it.
Okay, so got to bring up the map.
But first, we'll need to gear up.
Now this is just.
Industries had personal defense technologies aboard the Stratocarrier. I placed a marker on our map where we'll find some.
This is just a starting area, so not much of a map. Using some glitches, you can actually come back in here, but that'll be another video for another day. So here we go. These things you will actually be get ammo from at later dates. These are just normally just ammo boxes. Yeah, let's press start. As you can see, this is our main loadout screen. So you've got weapon 1, weapon 2, if you had a second weapon. Shields, grenades, spikes. These are things you stick in the ground and they have one of three effects. They either give you a damage buff, a protection buff, or they regenerate your ammo. You then got stims, which they are one of five. One of them increases your melee strength. One of them increases your armor count. One of them repairs your armor. One of them...
I'm going to need another weapon option. I'm picking up a signal from a crashed mobile armory.
And one of them repairs your ego power.
Collect the necessary equipment as soon as possible so we can start looking for Mr. Von Bach.
Now, there should be enemies running around here, but... not sure where. Oh, there we go. Hey, Skittling. If you've watched the show, you'll be familiar with them. And in the show, they do not die that easily. And again, that pink dot is over in that direction. One interesting thing I have noticed, as I've done this tutorial a few times now through different characters, as I also play on the North American server, is... where it sends you for each of these shield and weapon in this area is actually completely random, because there's loads of these machines and so it just picks one at random and sends you to it. So this is a different route to before.
The light machine gun is big, loud and powerful. Its bursts are capable of crippling the enemy from both close and afar. Particular weapon types work better for specific situations, so you'll want to get used to switching back and forth between the primary and secondary weapons.
So yeah, as you can see, this is a pretty basic tutorial. Just tells you the very basic controls. And that's as far as the tutorial goes in this game. It shows you the controls and then says, go. there's a lot more deeper mechanics, and there is no attempt to explain them. So here we go, let's search for explosives.
This supply pod is filled with grenades. Grab one and equip it.
How about we grab them all? That would be much more efficient. Sometimes this menu as well, as you just saw there, takes quite a while to come up.
I think you already know how this works. Pull the pin, throw, and get out of there.
I do like that they don't bother trying to explain how a grenade works, because it's a grenade.
Now that we're geared up, it's time to train you on the ego powers.
Here we go. I don't think I've ever done this here before.
First, we'll try Cloak. While using Cloak, you are completely invisible to enemies. Use the power to sneak up behind the projections and attack. Now we'll test the overcharge power. While using overcharge, your damage inflicted on the enemy is significantly increased. Shoot the projection while overcharge is activated. I'll enable the decoy power now. Decoy allows us to create a projection in your likeness that will fool and distract the enemy. Take down the projections while they're distracted by your decoy. The blur power is now enabled. Blur will allow us to move at extreme speeds and increases melee strength during close combat. With blur active, rush the projections and strike them with melee attacks. You must activate the blur power and strike these projections with melee attacks.
There we go.
And strike these projections with melee attacks.
Now, this guy here, he didn't see any of that.
You'll need to choose an ego power from
except for me activating that power. So he's probably like, what the hell was that? But in a minute he'll be like, oh, I understand now. So now we have to choose one. So we either get the decoy, which, well, as you saw, it creates a hologram which they follow. What she doesn't explain is if you try and activate it again while it is active, you will actually swap places with your hologram, which is actually very cool. Overcharge increases your damage of your weapon. It's what a lot of people choose as their first one. Blur makes you run a lot faster, increases melee attacks. That's it pretty much. And then Cloak, I prefer this one as a starter just because it allows you to hide from battles if you are getting destroyed too much. So let's just unlock that.
Nice choice. Stealth is the best power for surprise and subtlety.
Oh, I need to actually equip it. If you unlock something for the first time, you also need to equip it.
Can anyone hear me? I need help down here. It looks like the mutants are getting organized for an attack.
As you can see...
No, we better help her.
My yellow experience bar at the bottom is actually almost filled up. Let's see if I can... Let me check some menu. Oh, I don't have access to the menus yet. Let me just... kill a few more. Just so I can level up. Because it'll just make me a tiny bit stronger. And I'm wondering how it will bugger up the tutorial, actually. Yeah. It will, won't it? Actually, they probably have a safeguard in place to stop you leveling up. So yeah, all these pink dots are other players. And those explosions going off are actually for them, not for me. As you can see, there are loads of new people joining the game just because it's about to go free to play. And so they've picked up a cheap copy.
Those creatures are actually humans. However, their DNA is severely mutated.
So yeah, here we are in the game. Almost. We just got to get past that wall. I must apologise because I'm used to obviously my higher level character who can stay in the fight a wee bit longer than
we need to shut these dudes down. finding any survivors.
That's some blood.
Next. Shields.
I have the ability to hack into most computer systems. Get to that thorium reactor, and I'll see what I can do.
So as you can see, it's a pretty basic shooter. And my aim sucks. Whoa.
Feeling bad.
Should probably go interface with this thing.
Let's check out that reactor. I'm sure we'll be able to use it to our advantage.
Excellent. Oh.
I was able to reactivate the fissile materials. The reactor will overload and blow this entire base off the map. But we'll need to keep the mutants from disrupting the process.
What did you do to that thing? It looks like it's going to explode!
No surrender! Push them back!
The reactor is overloading. Keep it going!
So yeah, basically just got to protect this thing as it slowly overloads. It's almost like, how many waves of enemies am I going to have to fight while this overloads?
Keep those mutants away from the reactor.
It is actually possible to fail this and have them disarm it, and you have to redo it all. There we go, there's the tutorial. And once this next loading screen is out of the way, because this is actually now loading you into the main world.
What will die?
Special on Nangos are after Nolan and Nerissa.
There we are.
There's still a bounty on my head, so I need you to find out what they know.
Varys has another contract available, and he's offering more than usual, which is suspicious.
Okay.
We should meet him at the crater.
I'm going to wait for these all to stop talking, because basically it's giving me a load of missions at the moment.
I have received a dire message from Meguel, a former colleague of mine. She says the disease has reached the town of Defiance. Earth Republic soldiers went to the abandoned Cronkite bunker to send them the vaccine via a retrofit missile. However, we have not heard back from them since. I need your help in getting in there to launch that missile before the plague and Defiance gets worse. Meet me at the bunker. We cannot fail.
So yeah, here we are. In the game. That was where we just were. You can't go back there, except with a glitch. Well, now I'm going to talk you through some basic menus. So, press start, come here. And so as you've already seen, gun weapons, you can select one of two. Got your shield, grenade, spike, stim, and vehicle, which haven't got any of these yet because I haven't technically unlocked them. As you saw, I did actually level up, which allows me to choose one of these perks. And so, like say, for instance, this one, on a critical kill, I get some ammo back on my current gun. Which is actually really, really good. Like, especially if like you're using a sniper gun with this. Because you're doing one shot, one kill, 1% ammo regen is you're one bullet back. You never run out of ammo. So, we'll unlock that. And perks automatically equip if there is a spot to equip them in when you unlock them. And as you can see, the rest of those are got red writing across them saying at level 50, 100, 200, 300, 450, 600, 800 and 1000 I'll unlock a new perk slot. You then can have up to 5 different loadouts if you paid for the game, like I did. If you are a free-to-play player, you only get 3 loadouts, I believe it is. Or is it might even be 2 loadouts if you're free-to-play. If you tab over to the next one, as you can see at the top, it has loadouts, and next to that has the right button bumper button icon. On PlayStation, obviously, that would be either R1 or L1 for the other side. This is called the Salvage Matrix. It allows you to upgrade your guns, add mods to them, basically just make your guns better. As you can see there, you can break down for resources, which basically just destroys the gun for money, attach mods, remove mods, retrieve mods, add mod slots, which allows you to add the mods, upgrade rating, and change weapon mastery bonus. Next is the Ego Grid. At any time, you can respec, as you can see there in the bottom right-hand corner, and it allows you to choose a different power altogether if you don't like the one you're using. It does cost some in-game currency. Next is boosts. You can buy boosts from the store for amounts of money, or a patron pass, which just gives you 20% off on everything except for score, for however long your patron pass is active. It's actually the most cost-effective way to do it, I believe. Next is a stat screen. So it has all your currencies, which is scrip, which is just your general money, bits, which is premium, key codes, which you use to buy lockboxes, which I'll get into at a later date, arc salvage, which you use to add the mod slots to your guns and actually also to buy key codes in conjunction with scrip. Arc spike batteries are a DLC only item, as are cerulean cores and arc forge. I will get into those at a later date, as you need to be about at least level 500 before you start using arc forge, and about the same for the arc spike batteries, and you don't want to bother with cerulean cores until you're like 3,000 or 4,000 ego. Then you have all your ammo counts, then your experience bar. Factions unlock at level 250. At the moment there are, as you can see, 8 of them, but I believe they are adding 3 more, or 4 more in the next update. Then you've got your skills on all your weapons. So you've got assault rifles, submachine guns, light machine guns, yada yada yada. And, well, as you can see, there's all of them, and then 3 different types of vehicles. Runners, Cerberus, and Rollers. Runners are quad bikes, ATVs, those kind of things. Cerberus are 4-person vehicles with turrets on the back, only used in PvP and co-op maps. And then Rollers are just the other type of cars that are 2 or 4-person cars. Then you've got your inventory, which, as you can see, mine is very small at the moment. I've got a max inventory of 70, and I have 4 items. Free-to-play players, when you start, you'll have an inventory of 35. Now, I don't know if you can see here on this chat here, but there is items in, well, white, which is what the ego or the game is saying to you. You've then got yellow, or it might be green depending on how your screen is, which is basically your friends, what they're doing in the game. So as you can see, like Manic has left a match, Baldy Gargoyle has left a match. Obviously they were doing a co-op map or a competitive map. Then you've got zone chat, which, well, it's what's happening in the zone, in your particular server, what people are saying to each other. Sometimes it obviously, as with all games, it can get a bit nasty. Have 3 friends online simultaneously. Not difficult. Okay, so this is what I've just shown you through. This is your main menu. If you hold down one of the triggers on the Xbox, it brings up this wheel, which you can then move around with this icon. It's driven by the mouse on the PC, so you don't have to try and use some weird arrow key combination. Here you have goals, which, if I actually select it, is basically loads of tasks. So for instance, let's choose enemy groups. Mutant observation, I have to kill a mutant cleaver, a rifleman, a shotgunner, a grenader, a minigunner, and complete a minor mutant artful. That will get me 5 ego levels and some information about mutants, like who they are, where they've come from. As you can see, for season 1 there are 108 of them. A lot of them are like this, discover, just drive around the map and go everywhere. But then you get ones more like this, which is get to level 4000, fully upgrade 80 perks. It's a bit more difficult. But the rewards are 40 more levels. So as soon as you hit level 4,000, if you've done all the other three, you just suddenly go up another 40 levels and you get that armor. How cool is that? It's beautiful. And then you've got episodes, which are actually season one episodes. And as you can see, these are all undone on this one. And I actually believe they won't trigger as done. It will trigger under replay one, which will actually be really annoying. And then you've got your DLC 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And so let's say Artek Revolution, got Chimera, and you've got six things within there. Let's say Snakebite 2 is one of the hardest of those to get, just because you have to kill that many of the hardest things and you get 15 levels and a sword. Then you've got Season 2, and there are three episodes currently out for that, and each of those, just completing those three missions, those three missions, those three missions, gets you 45 levels. So as you can see, it is in some ways incredibly easy to level up. Then you have contracts, and it's actually 175 to work with the factions. I thought it was 250, I was wrong. So let me go back in, sorry. You got your map, it is the next one round. Everything within the lit up area is the game, what you can work with. I will go over what all the icons are in a minute, but as you can see, it is quite a large map. We're in pretty much the most northwest point of the map, and I'm going to set a waypoint there. And where is it? Over there. It is 10 kilometers away. Now, your running speed is about running speed. So if you were to run there, it's how long would it take you to run 10 kilometers? It's a good hour and a half maybe, to run all the way from there to the bottom of the map. Driving, it's more like 10 minutes. Icons. Obviously, this blue thing here is you, on which way you're pointing. Fast travel point. Extraction point, which means if I get killed, this is where I will be teleported back to. This means that there is a main mission, and it is here. If I scroll down here, this little icon here, I know you can't really see it too well, but it is actually a little clock. It means that there's a time trial there. These are the episode missions, tying into Season 1 and Season 2. This here is a rampage, which is to do with, just a horde of enemies will come at you and you'll be given a big gun. You've got to kill them all. This here is a side mission, actually, which is just something to do on the side, away from the main storyline. You don't have to do them, but it's experience, it's money, it's weapons, it's good to do them. And this here is another main mission, but this is actually a DLC main mission. This red thing here is an Arkful. Pretty much what you're here for is Ark. You're an Ark hunter. It's what you're there to do, is find these things. Basically, you go there and 3 to 5 waves of enemies come at you, you kill them all, and you get loads of rewards. This here is where one of the Ark Falls can actually be cooled down using one of those Ark Spike batteries that I told you about earlier. As you can see here, there's another episode mission, another Ark Fall episode mission, time trial. The little plus symbols, they're hotshots, so it's a test of skill. You'll have to try and use your sniper rifle to just get like 50 headshots in a row type thing as enemies are running around. This yellow circle is what's known as an incursion. What will happen is, as you're driving around normally, there are just roadside emergencies, just like crashed cars and being attacked by enemies. Basically, this, you do a set of them in a row, and basically these move around, and then you end up somewhere. And for this one, the particular location you end up is here, and you'll fight a huge battle, and it's really good fun, really good rewards, and a bit manic. So as you can see, that's pretty much all that's over the map. This here is one of the DLCs. It's an arena. It's actually a mission that you go from there, and then I think you do another one here, and another one here, and then the actual arenas are here. And then you got down to San Francisco, and there's another incursion going on here, and this will move around the San Francisco area, and then end up, I think, here, which is the bathhouse. So yeah, that's the map. Pretty much everything. You can, at any point, kind of go, oh, don't want side missions, don't want hotshots, don't want time trial, don't want rampage. You know, I don't want episodes showing, don't want Thor Nero. I don't want them because I don't have the DLC to cool them down, so I don't care. And now your map is suddenly a lot less busy. Going on to the next area is Incel, which is the very little that the game gives you. It's not very good. The stuff on Defiance data and hopefully that I'll be doing in my videos will be a bit better. Next is Defiance Store. Now, as you can see, that says 80. I will show you what that does at the end of the video. It's a bit nuts. Settings. There are some very important things you need to do in here. One, have damage. Make sure damage numbers are on, so you can actually see if you're hitting your enemy. Next one, mass breakdown filter. Select that, and it will, by default, be at epic or below. You want to put it on uncommon or common. So basically, it doesn't mean you accidentally destroy your guns, which if you do, they're gone. Nothing can be done. Then you've got more kind of things. You can change your character. You can change your character voice here. Then you've got graphical options, sound options, controller options. The controller actually is fully rebindable. You can change what any button does in this game. For a console game, this is pretty unique as far as I'm aware. Not many console games allow that. There's actually way too many PC games that don't allow that. Then you've got your account, so you can log out, support desks and stuff if you have problems with the game, like someone's causing you a problem or there's a bug. Then you've got your chat. I usually have mine at about 2.5 bars here, just so it's not too big, not too small. Have this at half because if it's any more, it stays up forever and never goes away. And if it's any less, it bugs and just doesn't go away. Personally, I have profanity filter off. And you want to have this to max, which allows you to have 4 tabs, which I'll show you in a minute, which allows you to choose what's on them. I personally have tab number 1, everything, active. Tab number 2 is just system, errors and rewards. Tab 3 is group, team, clan, officer, private and whisper. Basically, because all of these things for me are going to be from the same group of people. And then tab 4 is just everything else in a separate one. So area, chat, zone, private and whispers. Actually, private and whispers don't really need to be in there, nor does ego. So they're what I usually have as my 4. And what they are is down here where you've got this, if you tab over. So this is just, say, my rewards, the things that I'm picking up, as you can see, pistol ammo, assault rifle ammo, and credits and stuff, and then what my friends are doing, so that's system notifications. If I was in a clan or a group or anything, things would come up here. And then this is just the zone chat and area chat, whereas this is everything that all together. It's just personally how I like it. So if we go back into the menus, next one is matchmaking. Pretty self-explanatory. Matchmaking, you know, it's matchmaking. One of those actually seems to be taken out. Which one's that? Is that Shadow War? Oh, interesting. There's actually a Shadow War, which is an open world PvP, and for some reason that's disabled for me. I'm not sure why. Co-op maps, exactly as they sound, they're just maps that you do in cooperative mode, and 4 people go in, and you do the map. Arenas, it's horde-based enemies. You can do it on your own or in a group. And then you've got PvP. And you can either do quick match, which just finds you the next match which is about to start or has already started and just chucks you in. So you might be in any of those 4. And then there's Shadow War, as I said. The next one is social. If you have any friends who play the game, they'll come up here with like what their character name is, their clan, their level. As you can see, they're all... the clan I'm in, and my main character, which is Nuclear Armor. If you want to found a clan, you need to be level 25 and have 5,000 scrip. And as you can see, I'm level 20 and I've got 400 scrip. Not quite there. But I can join a clan. If someone asks me to join theirs, I can join. chat. Last 50 people to talk in the area. Last 50 people to talk in the zone. Group, team, and clan. Obviously, group, team, and clan, they're going to be empty for me because I haven't been in a group, haven't been in a team, and I'm not in a clan. Find player. If you know a friend who's playing and they happen to be online, you can just type their name in here and boom, you've got them. If you happen to play on the Xbox European servers, feel free to look me up and I'll get you an invite for our clan. Sorry, I just had a fly land on me. So yeah, that's pretty much all the main menus, except for the Defiance store, which allows you to buy premium items and costumes and lockboxes, which gets you chances at weapons and the patron pass and inventory slots and character loadouts and hold more Arc Forge or key codes and rename your character and redo your character. So if you actually decided, oh god, I don't like how he looks, or you know, I want to be a female character or I want to be a male character, you pay 720 bits, which is like a fiver, and boom, you've got it. Well, my friend there has just got a legendary hatchling grenade, which is very rare. If you tab over, have your claim items. If you're like me and have brought the DLC and brought the season pass and you're an old player, basically the game gives you a load of things for all of those. So these are all costumes. You should only have one of each of these, but for some reason it's bugged when you make a second or third character and it gives it to you multiple times, which for the costumes it doesn't really matter because you can't sell or break them down. You just, and it doesn't duplicate them in your inventory. It's silly. But here I've got two of those shields, so I can equip one because it's better than my shield and break down the other one for resources, so I'll be richer. Then you've got a load of pistols and assault rifles and shotguns. This one, actually, you will not be able to get unless you enter the Season 1 Ego codes, which are no longer available, as well as this Thundershock and I think the Plaguebringer and the Hydra. Then I've got a few cars to claim, which are from the DLC. A grenade, kits, arc salvage, stashes, skills for my guns. Customization redo, actually, which allows me to completely change my character, just because if you buy DLC 1, the Cast of Encharge kit, it gives you one of these as part of it. And then a load of inventory slots, and yeah, an extra perk, and all of these things. So what I'm actually going to do, is just so you can see, is I'm going to claim all these. So type. Let's take you. Oh, I don't really want to take you, but there we go. Let's take all these skills. I'm now level 66. Just because, if I go back here and tab back over to here, as you can see now, I'm level 6 in assault rifles. Every time you level up a gun, you get 4 levels in the game. So, boom. If you have all these things like I do, you instantly get a load of levels. Let's claim all these outfits. Now I'm level 66, and all of these guns and stuff, they all say level 0, as you can see. But what it is when you claim them, if I claim that shield and tab over, that's now a level 66 shield, which is actually doing, it's less effective actually than my shield, but it's just the way things are. So I'm going to claim everything here just so you can see what it is possible to get, except for the blade mod, just because I don't want to accidentally break that down. So I've got cars, got 3 of these Raptors, which only should have 1. Got a granny bike and a quad bike, new type of grenade, recruit kits, arc salvage, arc breaker stash, and Von Bach gunslinger cache. And as you can see here, a grenade just appeared. Now that's because I have already got one of those, because it's, if something appears there, it means you've already got it. So as you can see, after claiming all that stuff, I now have blue frag grenades instead of yellow, which means they do more damage. I've got bio grenades, I've got frag, pyro, which is fire, and shrill, purple, because they were all reward. Spikes, I've got damage spikes, and protection spikes. I've got a blade of armour, ruler, and power stem. Let's go for power, just because it instantly recharges your power. I've then got this kind of granny bike, which is what most people call it. Got Dodge Challenger, pretty sweet. Four-person vehicle, pretty sweet. And a quad bike, pretty sweet. So let's just stick with that car. And because I've leveled up past level 50, that gives me an extra perk slot. And one of the things that I got was this here, which gives me extra ammunition. How cool is that? So yeah, I now have the salvage matrix open and I can do things within it. Ego grid, boosts. You will also get, if you play every day, you will get a daily boot, get a daily reward box, which gives you some script, some arc salvage, and so on and so forth, and at random one of these six boosts for 2 hours. And it's 2 hours of playtime, not 2 hours just in general. So if you're online, you claim it and go offline. When you come back online, you'll have 1 hour, 59 minutes, and 59 seconds. As we saw that before, and now inventory screen. So I actually ended up with three other shields from that. A load of pistols, all the stuff. So basically, you just need to go through and decide which do you like. As bizarrely, none of these shields... Let's see, actually, I think... Actually, yeah, you're better than Von Bark shield. Though I don't want to break it down just because it's unique. So that's favourite that. Let's favourite that. If you write on the D-pad, it favourites things, so you don't accidentally destroy it. Let's take one of these pistols, because they're all the same. One of them, one of them, one of them. Basically, let's just compare it all later. Grinder, Thundershock, Surge Nanofragger, Plaguebringer, EMC. As you can see, there's lots and lots of different guns in this. So yeah, if we do a mass breakdown, are you sure you want to destroy 9 uncommon items? Yes. Drum roll. And there we are. Just, you should have gone. Ah, of course, yeah, because I said it's uncommon or below. So you can break them down individually, which is what I am doing here. So yeah, that's pretty much the intro to the game. And now, because I'm out of the menus, all of this stuff that had been going on in those menus is now going to pop up again. If I teleport while all this is happening, it will just happen again and again. So yeah, that's pretty much it. As I said, ego power doesn't really matter because you can change it. Character class doesn't matter. Race doesn't matter. It's just what you actually choose to equip your character with is what actually matters in the game. And yeah, so that's pretty much it. This has been Magnus Rune, and part one of my videos, and hopefully you'll join me another day for another video. I will probably be doing the others from my other account, just because it will have more of the game. See you later.